Let me start by saying hi in Chavacano. Hola, ¿qué tal ustedes? Y yo sí, Diego. What's up, language learners? Today, I'm gonna be reacting to Chavacano. So, to break it down for you, I'm gonna get started with a reaction to the Chavacano language to see how much I, as a Spanish speaker, can understand. Then, I'm gonna move on to telling you a little bit of the history of how this Creole language was created. And finally, my favorite part, I'm gonna tell you some fun facts about Chavacano. So before getting started, it is important to point out that Chavacano is the only Spanish-based Creole from Asia, and it is spoken in parts of the Philippines. So what is the dictionary definition of Creole? So according to Her Majesty Madame Merriam-Webster, she says that Creole is a mixing of different languages into a new one within a fairly brief period of time. I'm very curious, guys. Do you see the creation of new Creole languages right now? Please comment below. So it turns out there is a wide range about the estimates of how many speakers of Chavacano there are. And the estimates range from 300,000 to close to 1,000,000. And I think it's more accurate to say that there are more speakers because Zamboanga City is a large city and it is a common language used in this place. All right, so today we're gonna be reacting to another channel that is Ana La Viajera. She's a Chavacano Filipino girl that travels and sometimes makes videos in Chavacano. So today she will be taking us on a tour around Zamboanga City. So let's check it out.
Hola, buenos días amigos. Bienvenido a mi canal Ana La Viajera. Takikita ahora na mi ciudad, Asia's Latin City, also known as the Southern Capital of the Philippines, Zamboanga City. Na este video, dale con es mira mga comida na ya puede kame comer y también mga lugar na ya visita kame. Pues, vámonos.
I mean, I understood that part. I am unsure if she was speaking Spanish or English at times. I definitely hear some words in Spanish and some words in English. Maybe they are just, that's just the way Chavacano is because it has been influenced by so many languages. So let me know if you guys have more insight on that, but I understood very much the context of that little bit that she said. She said she's gonna be making a video about the food and some places that she's gonna visit in Asia Latin City, which is Zamboanga. All right, let's keep going.
Okay, cosa tiene aquí casamiento? ¿Puede aquí hacer el boda?
Ah, puede aquí hacer casamiento.
Estamos ahora dentro del National Museum, cerca del Fort Pilar, y como puede ustedes mirar, me yo ya cambié ya gané sila el color del building, ya pinta sila white en vez de este o color. Es brillo, vamos el original de suyo design.
Well, that second part again was very clear. She was wondering if it was possible to have a wedding there. It wasn't too clear what the lady responded. She sounded really far away, but casamiento. I mean, in Spanish we use the word boda, but I think casamiento is very clear and it's kind of a synonym. Then she again used a lot of English when describing the color of the walls, and the word for brick sounded something like ladrillo, which is very, very similar.
Del Fort Pilar, te puedes mirar el vista atrás, vamos el paseo del mar. Cabar, nacosal, vamos el centro latino, edificio del centro latino. Después también nacosal de suyo tiene un university, conocido también.
Alright, once again, I noticed a lot of similar words and that was super fantastic and easy to understand. I didn't understand 100% everything, but the general context, absolutely. So I think if I had to give a ranking to Chavacano, it would be 4 out of 5 stars. I think it's very, very close to Spanish, if not probably the closest language. And I think just spending some time talking to the people, I could get used to what they are saying and understand it even more. Now let's take a look at the history of Chavacano, and this will reveal a lot of a connection that we Latinos have with the people from the Philippines, which I think is pretty mind-blowing and really cool. So in the 1500s, Spain was huge, and they were probably the coolest empire of the time. The sun never sets over the Spanish Empire. Yes, Spain was the empire of the time, and when they discovered America, they kind of hit a big jackpot, but they wanted to keep expanding it. They really wanted to go to Asia to get in contact with all of the spices that initially what they were looking for. And let's not forget that the Europeans were looking for Asia when they discovered America, so they kind of messed up. So even though these colonizers, whenever I hear that word because I just watched Black Panther and yeah, my mind is a little bit there in that mindset. I was gonna say that these colonizers, the Spanish, for the most part, they learned the language because they were trying to convert the locals to their religion, to Catholicism. So that's the reason why the rest of the Philippines, they may have an influence of Spanish, but they don't speak a Spanish Creole like it is the Chavacano. So you may be wondering, how was it different in Zamboanga and Cavite where Chavacano is spoken? Well, it all boils down to location, location, location. So in the city of Zamboanga in particular, there was a very, very important fortress called the Fortress of San Jose that today is known as Fort Pilar, and we actually saw in the video of Ana La Viajera that she was visiting this place. So in this fort, there was a big congregation of many kinds of people. There were a lot of Visayan soldiers that were moved from other parts of the Philippines. There were also Spanish soldiers that were brought from the Americas, so from places like Mexico and Peru, and also Spanish monks that came directly from Spain. Sounds like the beginning of a bad joke. So a Visaya soldier, a Mexican soldier, and a Jesuit Spanish monk walk into a fortress and... So even though the fort was abandoned, a lot of these people remained and they decided to merge and interact with the community more and more. And whatever combination of language they were speaking eventually became widespread all over. Eventually, the influence of the language became permanent and standardized in this form that is Chavacano as we know it today. I dug and dug and dug and couldn't find how the history was similar in the city of Cavite, which is actually quite far from Zamboanga. So I'm curious, and please comment below if you know how the Chavacano evolved in Cavite. What is important to know is that Chavacano became super, super important and today is widely used in these cities, is used in education, in print, in media, and it's just a really amazing and beautiful language that sometimes gets overlooked. Now we move to my favorite part of the video. I'm gonna share with you some fun facts about Chavacano. So fact number one is about the differences between Chavacano in different regions. Apparently, and I want people to confirm this, the Chavacano spoken in Zamboanga is more heavily influenced by people of the Americas, by these soldiers that came directly from America, from Mexico and Peru and other places. And the Chavacano spoken in Cavite is mostly influenced by European Spanish. I'm curious to know if you guys have more details about this. Now, did you know that Chavacano follows a completely different sentence structure to Spanish? They start with the verb, then they have the subject, and then the object. In Spanish, we usually have the subject, the verb, and then the object. So, for example, in Chavacano, they would say something, and forgive my pronunciation here, they would say, "Ta compra el maga negociante con el tierra," which means the businessmen are buying land. In Spanish, we would say first the businessman, like in English, el negociante compra tierra. So a little bit different. Another fun fact is the origin of the word Chavacano. Apparently, Chavacano is an old Spanish word to call something ordinary. And that was the way they referred to this way of speaking of the local people of the Philippines. They thought they were taking Spanish and just making it into something that they didn't consider the legit form of Spanish. But I mean, they're just creating a new language. That's the way languages are created. That's the way languages evolve. That's the way Spanish was created. So even though they considered something vulgar, I mean, who can have the authority to say that? And the last fact is, did you know that in some informal writing, the letters ñ, which is the N with the little squiggly thing, and the double L are actually spelled differently. They use the NY and the LY. So that's the case in some informal writing. So that just shows kind of the evolution of Chavacano, which is mostly a spoken language and just recently has been standardized into a more written version, usually following the rules of Spanish, but not always. All right, guys, so please, I want to rely on our community, so you guys let us know, how did you do understanding Chavacano, and please let us know where you're from so we can get a little bit of context. Also, please comment below if you have any more insights, any more fun facts or history of Chavacano. Please educate us, our community keeps growing thanks to you guys, so please keep commenting below. And don't forget to give us a like if you enjoyed this video, and please subscribe.